As I mentioned, you will need to define the design challenge before the design sprint. To help you decide on the design challenge, here are some things that you can do. First, you should interview key stakeholders. Stakeholders can be investors, designers, or engineers. They could also be someone like the user or anyone else related to the product. Second, you should identify or review any of the use cases for the product. Next, you should review all relevant user research. And finally, you should review any current designs that you have on the product. If you're planning your first design sprint, it's likely that you will not have any current designs. In that case, you should focus on these first three tasks when going about the design sprint. At Udacity, we recently planned two design sprints. The first design challenge involved redesigning the entire user journey through a nanodegree from the time a user hears about a nanodegree, the time that that user graduates and advances their career or lands a new job. A second design sprint focused on one particular part of our user journey. We started to think about how to redesign student support through forums, code reviews, and other methods. You'll need to plan a specific design challenge like these for your own product, and it's likely that it will be for the main user journey, navigation, and key tasks that users will perform. The design challenge statement is what you need to actually write, and it creates a single focus for what is the output of the design sprint. A good challenge statement should have a couple key qualities. First, it should be relevant to the highest priority work of the team, and it should be tied to a purpose or a key result. It should also be concise and to the point, and hopefully inspiring for yourself. The design challenge statement should also include a target audience or segments of that audience. And finally, for projects that are in progress, you'll want to include a launch time stated in terms of years or quarters. So would you want to be launching in Q1, Q2, Q3, or Q4? Your design challenge statement will identify the tangible items that you want to have at the end of the design sprint. And at the least, it should answer one of two questions. What are you missing that you need critically? Or what is the riskiest decision or hypothesis that you want to test with your users? You can use a gap analysis like this one to determine what the product is missing or what's one of the riskier decisions or hypotheses that you need to test. This checklist is linked in the instructor notes. Here's one example of a challenge statement. You might design a mobile app that helps a visitor plan and find the most relevant, personalized, and exciting activities to do in a city, keeping in mind that the visitor only has one day for their visit. The deliverables in this case would be to get wireframe sketches for ideas that would be implemented in Q3 of 2015. Your design challenge statement should be similar and have components like the what of the deliverable, the time frame for when you need it by, and also a clear user with what they'll be doing in the application or the product. Now, the goal for your first sprint will likely to be to map out the basics of your new website or app, including some flows, pages or screens, and the basic navigation. Now that you know about a challenge statement, I'd like you to think about one for your own design sprint. What would you create, and for what kind of users, and by when would you create it, and in order to do what? Take a minute to think about this, and then write your answer in the box below. Don't feel like you need to commit to this one design sprint challenge for your own design sprint. You could actually change this later in your final project.